messy, and we're cause for chaos.
We're not doing Disney.
What? But you told me.
I said we'll eventually do Disney.
Fine.
Besides, today we'll be ranting about something so close to my heart. And this year it's celebrating its 25th anniversary.
Zelda?
It has defined a generation of video games with its epic story, kick-ass music, and memorable characters.
Zelda? Zelda.
We're doing Zelda.
Yes, I knew it!
Let's go back to the beginning. In 1987, The Legend of Zelda was released in the US. It was a simple story of boy saves princess from evil, and of course it wound up spurning a huge franchise.
We weren't even born when the first Zelda was released, but I can say I have tried playing it. It was hard, and lacked story like most 80s games. But hey, everything has to start somewhere, right?
Today we're going to look at some of the most bizarre things to have come from this franchise, particularly from the games we know best. Ocarina of Time, Majora's Mask, Wind Waker, and Twilight Princess, which also happens to be the biggest games from the franchise in terms of story, gameplay, and graphics.
We're basically a fanboy's reality check.
Anyways, let's just get right into our rant, starting with the Zelda dungeons. Now, I like the Zelda dungeons. I think every Zelda fan can agree that the Zelda dungeons are the core of the game. The dungeons are what make Zelda Zelda. I mean, if you didn't have the dungeons, then what would be the point of playing it? Really. Like, there's all kinds of cool things in the dungeons. You explore, you find keys, you find weapons to help you defeat the bosses. It's a load of fun. Like, that's, you know, one of the reasons why I play Zelda so much is because it's so much fun solving the different dungeons and everything. But there is one problem.
Why is it a pretty question that Ganon leaves you the essentials to make you powerful? Like, he's the one who leaves the keys, which eventually gets you the weapons, which gets you to beat the temple, and you keep getting more and more powerful every time. In Ocarina of Time, it made sense, at least for the first part when you're a kid, because you gotta get the spiritual stones so that he can get into the sacred realm, right? But after that, it makes no sense, and he's basically giving you everything to defeat him. Like, why is he giving you the power?
Because he's a masochist.
Well, yeah, but, like, what, is he getting aroused by a teenager coming after him?
Which brings me to my point. Everyone wants in Link's pants. And he doesn't even have any pants. Like, look in Ocarina of Time. So many people are attracted to Link, it's not even funny. My first example, the Po collector, when you're an adult. He's like sitting there collecting Po, like the ghost thingies, and he's like, "You're just so handsome. If I had your good looks, I'd be running a different kind of business." What? What? Thank you.
Plus, every woman you meet in that game wants you too. There's Saria, who is a perpetual child, a fish girl, a ranch girl, a princess, and even a desert chick. Holy harem of woman, Batman.
There has even been some speculation that Navi the fairy fell in love with you. I'm not making this up, people. She knew it when she left, like, you know, in the ending where she kind of like flutters off through the window and you're like, oh, that's kind of sad, but not really. Well, she left because, one, she knew it wouldn't work because you're a person and not a little ball of light. And two, you're 9.
I like to think she left because she knew we were plotting to kill her the next time she said.
Hey, listen!
Yeah.
I like to think that he did kill her. That's why he went hunting for her in Majora's Mask. Just so that he could end her. Because why Link would even want to be with that fairy bitch is beyond me.
Okay, so what about sexism in the game?
Sexism?
Yeah, sexism. You know, like, because all the women in the Zelda franchise are completely useless. Like, the only one I understand is Zelda because she's, like, that's her role. She's the damsel in distress, but...
But When she was chic, she was kind of cool, actually. I mean, she taught you songs on her harp, and then she got captured. Wow. Talk about a good role model. Even in Twilight Princess, Zelda is portrayed as this, like, strong, you know, totally competent woman. I mean, she even has a sword man. Like, she looks like she's ready to battle, and then she just drops her sword, and suddenly Zan takes over, and everything's in Twilight, and you realize that she can't do anything unless Link is there holding her hand.
Probably what's, like, the worst one is Wind Waker. Like, as Tetris, she's completely competent. She's a ship's captain, and she can fight, and she's awesome. But as soon as she goes, like, into Princess Zelda mode, she's useless.
That part of the game actually really pissed me off. Sorry to interrupt you. But, like, you see her as Tetris, she even takes on Ganon, okay? She, like, runs at him, and he grabs her and everything. But it's like, you know, it's like, okay, that was, you know, it's still, she's badass. And then suddenly she turns, first off, she turns white. What the hell is that about?
There's another problem right there.
Okay, we're keeping this clip just because that's funny. Like, that, yeah. Yeah, she turns white. She then turns into Zelda, and she's like, oh, I don't remember anything at all. I'm completely useless. Yeah, she suffers from damsel in distress syndrome, which we see a lot in pop culture nowadays. Like, you just have to look at the Superman movies, Lois Lane. Like, she's a reporter, you know, she's ready to go into things. She thinks she's strong, but then when she's put into a tough situation, she has to be rescued.
The worst one ever, Claire from Heroes. Oh my goodness.
She's fucking invincible. I'm sorry, I had to put that in there. And yet she's the most incompetent female I have ever seen.
She causes most of the problems in that series. But we'll go into that rant later. In fact, that's probably going to be an episode in the near future about Heroes. But back on topic.
Back to Zelda. What about the Gerudos? You know, they're an all-woman thieving female race. They're kind of cool, actually. Gotta admit, they're...
No. No. No, they are the worst of all. They are idiots! They're so stupid! So think back to Ocarina of Time. The Gerudos befriend Link, which is ridiculous! Ganon is their king! Come on!
That's awkward.
Yeah. Like, imagine what it would have been like when Ganon came to visit. Ganon, some crap went down. Don't get mad. Don't get mad. We may have helped that kid you hate.
He was just so good. I mean, like, capturing him and you know, throwing him in the little dungeon thingy and he kept just escaping and he kept shooting us with these, like, magical arrows because we never died. I got shot 5 times.
I got shot 7 times. Anyways, we gave him a pass because how could we not? I mean, he was just so skilled. It was great, actually.
Kind of cute. Anyways, because we gave him the pass, he kind of went to the spirit temple. And,
yeah, I have to tell him. Okay. I don't know how to tell you this, but your mothers are dead. Nuts.
You know what else is really annoying about the Zelda series? There's just this one character.
I know who you're talking about.
I think every Zelda fan knows who I'm talking about. His name is Tingle. He wears green tights and red underwear, and he likes to pretend he's a fairy despite the fact that he's 35 years old.
Yeah.
In Japan, that may seem quirky and cute. In North America, he's a fucking pedophile.
It's scary. Really, it's scary.
He's even got a mole.
He's probably the most hated character in, like, the Zeldaverse, basically. At least for Americans.
Okay, this is why I really hate Tingle. Okay, he goes around pretending he's a little happy fairy, and you're like, okay, whatever, I can deal with that Majora's Mask. Wind Waker. Oh my god. He decides that he'll help you decipher these maps so you can find the Triforce pieces or whatever that are spread all over the ocean, because, you know, that's what I want to do for 5 hours, is go around trying to hunt these damn Triforce pieces. Big mistake, Nintendo. Anyway, he's like, yeah, I'll decipher the maps for $499 or something along those lines, which is like rupees, actually. But he charges you an excessive amount. Your wallet doesn't hold enough rupees to get him to, like, it just takes forever to find the goddamn money, okay? And there's, like, you have to do this 8 times. And you have to endure his, I'm a happy fairy man, 8 times. No. No.
That was the moment that people hated him the most, and why at one point there was in the article where people just voted to have him murdered.
Thank you, IGN. We love you. IGN.
That's probably the only reason why he wasn't in Twilight Princess. So
there is the guy who runs the tent shop. I can't remember his name at the moment. Like the star shooting game. He's in the tent and he's evil. That's actually supposed to be based on Tingle's look. And if you look at him, he kind of does look a bit like Tingle. Yeah. But he's evil, so it's okay.
Yeah.
Tingle pretends he's a happy fairy when really he is evil. At least this guy knows that he wants money. Tingle just pretends, and he's really irritating. I don't understand Japan. They even have a shooting game with him on balloons or something on the DS. I don't understand the appeal. I don't. He's horrible.
Scary little man.
He is. He's also short, which makes him really creepy. He's a short guy. And in Twilight Princess, in Wind Waker, when he's like walking, he's like boop, 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 boop as he walks. It's not cute. He's 35 years old. Doesn't he have anything better to do than cosplay as a fairy child? It's so wrong.
I just realized that you just said that, and a lot of people cosplay as at least Link, which is a fairy child, and they're 35, so I'm just saying, you probably insulted a lot of people right there.
They can deal with it.
And that's that. Yeah, I don't know about you, but I'm pretty ranted out.
Yeah, I'm out of steam.
For now.
But if you're gonna take anything from this video, know that we are Zelda fanboys.
Now what? Someday you'll see, one day I'll be part of your world. What? I had to finish the song.
I'm leaving.
Sorry.